Hi, in this video I will be showing you one of the coolest tools I own, the Pinecil version 2. It's a budget-friendly yet feature-packed soldering iron made by Pine64. Later, I will customize it by swapping its shell for a transparent one and testing out some apps that work wirelessly with it via Bluetooth. Please note that this video isn't sponsored by Pine64 and the tool was purchased by me. All opinions and experiences are entirely my own. Let's start with the unboxing. The packaging is very simple, showing the soldering iron on the front and the contents of the box on the back. It includes a paper manual, the Pinecil itself, and a short soldering tip stored in foam. I would recommend testing if everything works correctly before doing any modifications, just in case there is a manufacturing defect and the tool needs to be returned. Before assembling the Pinecil, it is advised to clean the soldering tips first with some isopropyl alcohol and a paper towel so that no factory residue is left on them. Without doing so, there may be tip detection or temperature problems. To put together the soldering iron, you need to take out the screw on the front, then you can insert the soldering tip. After that, you need to put back the screw and tighten it so it holds the tip in place. You can switch this to a thumb screw in the future if you find yourself switching the tips frequently, as the Pinecil is compatible with both Pine64 short and TS100 normal length tips. Do note that shorter tips have lower resistance, usually 6.2 ohms instead of 8, and they might require more power to fully utilize them. To power it, you can either use the USB-C port or the DC Blu-ray connector on the back. But before that, please read the documentation, as it's easy to cause damage by supplying power to it wrong. For example, don't try powering it with both at the same time, or you might fry the internals. I will use my 45W Steam Deck charger in this video, which should give the Pinecil enough power to actually solder with. Weak power supplies won't be able to heat up the tip, but should still be enough to turn the soldering iron on. If you need a new one, Pine64 has the Pine Power 65W charger available in their store alongside the silicone USB-C cables. Now let me show you how the Pinecil works. For controls, there are two small buttons around the screen which are labeled with a plus and a minus. The Pinecil uses a 32-bit RISC-V CPU and has a 96x16 monochrome OLED display. It's running an open source soldering iron firmware, Iron OS. The tool is roughly 30 grams when fully assembled without modifications, and also has a Bluetooth low energy chip, enabling even more capabilities and cool projects which I will show later in the video. I really like how compact it is alongside with the option for USB-C, as it enables easier and more precise movement unlike other bulkier soldering irons I've used in the past. Its small weight and size are also perfect for tighter workspaces or for carrying around. There are lots of settings available to the user, but now it's time to see it in action. The tip heats up pretty fast and its temperature can be boosted temporarily by holding the plus button when needed. Please excuse my bad soldering here, since recording this I've gotten a lot better. Now that testing is done, it's time to do the shell swap. This is a straightforward process as it only requires taking out some screws and popping the stock shell apart to transport the inner parts into the new one. For this I found an easy method on YouTube by River Mochi, where a rod, in my case a chopstick, is inserted into a soldering tip space and pried up first to start taking the shell apart. For the first time, it might be harder to do this, and please don't be stupid like me, pry the bottom part outwards instead of the top one. The tip gets heated up with these two copper contacts, so it's important to not damage them, but if you do, you can get replacement parts from the manufacturer. They are held down by a pair of screws which hold the other internals in place as well. Make sure to keep your workspace organized to not lose them. In assembling the Pinecil back together, make sure to first insert the buttons on the top and put the little copper O-shaped part where the soldering tip would be inside. Tighten all the screws but don't overdo them or something might get damaged. Thank you. After the shell swap is complete, test if everything works correctly again. In my case, it detected the stock soldering tip fine on first try, but for some reason the other ones I've got from AliExpress didn't get detected, even though they worked perfectly fine before. To fix this, first I tried cleaning the tips, but that didn't help, so then I chose to take it apart again where I saw the two copper contacts were loose. Make sure to tighten these or else problems may arise just like here. I've also reassembled the old shell to store it away in case I need it again. Now it's time to do the firmware update. For this, I used PineFlash, another open source program. There have been many new features and bug fixes added to iOS since the Pine's August 2022 launch, including its Bluetooth capabilities. You might be asking, what can you do with Bluetooth in a soldering iron? Well, let me show you Yorick's website and Pinesem. Both are open source interfaces that can monitor and control your Pinesem remotely in the web browser by connected via BLE. iOS, the firmware that the Pinesem uses, is also compatible with Home Assistant, which enables you to automate various things. For example, you could start a fume extractor when the soldering iron is powered on. The community also made other mods like adding LEDs for better visibility during soldering and Hall effect sensors for detecting if the Pinesem is put into a magnetic stand so it can go back to sleep. There are many 3D models designed for the Pinesem as well, like storage boxes or stands, but for me this AliExpress carbon fiber case is enough. In conclusion, I highly recommend the Pinesem to anyone who is looking to get a new soldering iron. It's a really versatile and powerful tool for the price. With its open nature in terms of software and hardware, it allows for various cool customization options, encouraging people to also learn more. Pine64's goal of creating quality-driven products is clear in how well-documented and repairable the Pinesem really is. If you found my video useful and entertaining, consider subscribing or donating to my Ko-fi. These are the best ways to support me to do more cool things like this, and I wish you good luck in your next project. As an extra thank you for watching until the end, here are some behind-the-scenes footage of me making this video.